Why did I move to Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia as a Muslim Iraqi American? Let's talk about it. It's a busy street, so it's too loud. Let's go somewhere else. I just want to show you guys that. What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Ramadan Mubarak, it's Ramadan. It's Muhammad, Mo, Mo Dinar, Mo Money, whatever you know me as. Most of you guys are not gonna know me. There's 100 million viewers out there. A new channel, I decided to start a new channel because the other channel was just too dead. I haven't uploaded anything, I barely upload like what? Once a year, if that, and it was a lazy video. It wasn't like a good production either. I'm in Malaysia, I'm in Kuala Lumpur. Why am I here? Why did I come here? Who am I? What am I doing here? Why are you watching this? Why is this important? I hope you can hear me. The street is really busy, especially now because it's almost iftar time. I have low energy. I might look like I have a lot of energy, but trust me. No sugar, no coffee, no water. I've been fasting. Amazing, beautiful month. Just making these videos when you're fasting is kind of tough. So why would I move from America to Kuala Lumpur? Why now and why this city? Hopefully in this video, I'll break it down. I'll break down why I moved here, why I moved out of the US, why I picked this city, a lot of that. Originally, I'm from Iraq, moved to Arizona when I was like 12, 13 years old in March of 2001. Lived in Arizona most of my life, moved to Cali, moved to Los Angeles, 2014. I've been in the entertainment industry doing music, video related stuff, film, music videos. Man, for most of my life, since I was probably 16, 17, I've been filming on camera since I was 12, 11, even before that. So, always been obsessed with cameras, just never really obsessed with YouTube, right? Always traveled and always filmed my traveling, but never consistently uploaded on YouTube. So why did I leave America, a country that everybody wants to be in? Everyone in the world, when I tell them I'm American, but I don't live there, they're surprised. Like, wait, why? I thought this was the greatest country in the world, the American dream, blah, blah, blah. That's what I want to talk about mostly, but also why I picked this city to live in. Now, I've been traveling full time. I'm gonna show you guys the streets. Let's go in here. It looks less busy. It looks like I could film here compared to this street. So I've been traveling full time since 2021. I went on a big trip in 2018 and then 2019. Two big trips, 3 months apiece. Came here in 2019, I was in China. I lived in China for 3 months, got some business there, did some imports or exports to the US, imported some stuff from China at the time. Visited all the countries around here. And the one city that just screamed wow to me was Kuala Lumpur. And honestly, I mean, the more I travel, the more I become interested in other cities, and it became a norm, and it became basically easy for me to live anywhere. But I always remembered that there was something about this city. Just something screamed like, wow, this city is beautiful, this city is perfect, you gotta go back, you gotta go back. And I never went back, because I have a rule, I don't wanna double visit a country. I try not to, unless I have to. I try not to double visit countries because I don't wanna say it's a waste, but if you're on a mission to visit as many countries as you can, or travel, might as well go to new ones, right? Instead of just constantly, instead of wasting your money, going to a country twice. Now, why did I leave the US? Before I continue saying good things about Kuala Lumpur and what made me want to come here, why did I leave the US? What got me into traveling? What even got me interested in leaving the place? So America is home. I've never lived in Iraq. I left Iraq when I was 2. So the US is home to me, but it's one of those things where it's home, but not really, because you don't feel connected to the country, to the nation, to the ideology. I don't, at least. And I know a lot of people don't. And it has nothing to do with religion and race. It does, but I know a lot of people that are American, and they feel the same way. So it's not really about my religion or my race. It's just about the nation and how disconnected I believe it is from the world and what it means to be a human. So that was one of the main reasons that I was like, nah, I gotta leave the US eventually. I can't live there forever. I wouldn't raise kids there if I ever had any. So it just slowly built up this idea of, I gotta find a new place. And just like you guys, I watched travel vloggers, you know? It was less of them, 2019, 2018, 2020. There wasn't that many people traveling, or there was, but it wasn't as common as now. So watched a couple, got some ideas, just traveled around, went to Iceland, went to UK, and then went on a 3-month trip. Then in 2019, that was 2018. Then in 2019, went on another trip to Asia, Southeast Asia, China, and just fell in love with traveling. And then COVID happened. I had to stay in the US because everything closed down. The whole world was shut off. Continued working there, saving money. Was into crypto, so that's where most of my budget came for traveling. But basically saved a lot of money as much as I could. And in 2021, I packed my bags and I left. And I've been traveling full-time ever since, except a slight break. I took a six-month break from traveling. I was kind of tired of constantly moving around. I had forgotten that I need a home base. I had forgotten the idea of let's find a home base, let's settle somewhere. I just forgot that. So I took a break, went back to the US, lived in San Diego for 6 months, got a corporate job, and I was like, you know what? This is not me at all. Like, I couldn't even do a temporary. So I left again, and this is a result of that. I left about a month and a half ago, went to Iraq, a couple other countries, Vietnam, Indonesia, and then here. So we're here now. Hopefully this will be home base. Now let's get into why I'm in Kuala Lumpur and why I love it. It's Ramadan. And you know, as Muslims, we fast from sunrise to sunset. What's nice about this country, and I think Jakarta or Indonesia was the same way. I just went to like two markets there. There's these places called Ramadan bazaars. It's like a street food market with a lot of stalls, hundreds of stalls, or at least tens of stalls. There's a lot of them. With amazing food near mosques. So this is a mosque, this is a big mosque here. And we're gonna go grab some food. They also pass out food at the mosque. And this was where I'll break my fast. Then I'll continue the story of why I moved here. So this is Jalan Raja Alang Kampung Baru. So Kampung Baru is the area, and this is the Ramadan market, and that's the mosque here. I've been coming here literally every day since I moved here. Hello. Guys, the markets here are amazing. I've been coming here every day, and the food is just really, really, really good. Oh my God, look at the smoke. This is so good. We tried this last time. This is beef and lamb. Just amazing. See, this doesn't exist not only in the West. This isn't common even in Arabic countries. I spent Ramadan in Egypt and Iraq. We don't have this kind of thing. So that's why I'm impressed. And that's why I'm here every day. And this isn't the only one. There's one of these near almost every mosque or every area. From what I've heard, there's plenty. This is one of the busiest ones. There's another one that's also big. I think it's bigger than this. I forgot the name of it. I might go to that and film and make a video also. So if you guys like this, let me know in the comments and I'll go to the other one and film it. Because I want to go check it out. I just wasn't planning on making a video. But yeah, let's keep filming. Let's keep walking around. What is this?
Kebab.
Kebab.
Bun.
This one?
Yeah. We put the beef or chicken.
Oh, okay.
Then they put the mayonnaise.
Oh, mayonnaise.
Yeah.
Make me no mayonnaise.
No mayonnaise. Yeah. How many? Two.
One.
Okay. Order. I make it for you. Do you want?
Can I put beef?
Beef or chicken?
Beef.
Okay, order.
Yeah, I want no mayonnaise.
No mayonnaise, right?
Yes, sir. How much is this?
₱5 only.
₱5. Wow, look at that. So it's beef, onions, cucumber, vegetables.
No, no onion.
What is the white stuff?
This is cucumber.
Oh, cucumber.
Yes.
Oh. And what kind of sauce? What's the sauce?
No spicy, right?
Oh, small spicy. Yeah, it's not too spicy. Good. ₱5. And then one regular.
Yes.
There you go. Thank you. Thank you. Like, look at this market I'm in right now. I made a video about this. I'll post this right after here. So I have a whole video about this place. Hello, Bazaar Market. I just grabbed some food. And there's a lot of food. There's a lot of options. Whatever you crave is here. Local food, foreign food, Arabic food, everything. Only thing they don't have is falafel. This juice, the juice is so good. After a long day of fasting, especially today that I'm filming, I need a big glass of juice. Oh, let's get some chicken. Yeah, let's get some chicken. I'm gonna get some chicken. Oh, brother. I want some chicken.
All right, brother.
A chicken breast?
Yeah.
Breast?
No, no have.
You don't have breast?
Drumstick and...
So what is that? No. Oh, no. I don't like tail. This is wings?
Yes.
Oh, I'll take wings. Yeah, we'll take some chicken wings. I don't want no tail. That's the drum, the chicken drum. I don't want that. They like that. They like that here. I don't like that. I want wings.
How much?
How much are they?
50 cents.
Oh, 250. So yeah, two for five?
One piece, 2 ringgit for 50 cents.
Give me two.
Two.
And two.
Okay. This one, two. This one, two.
Yes.
Okay.
How much is this?
4 ringgit.
Four.
Okay. You want three?
No, okay. Two. It's okay. Yeah, two. Okay. No problem.
Sauce?
What kind? Yeah, please. Please, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
13.
So you just got some chicken wings, some drumsticks. Oh, some musica. This is so good also. So as I'm filming this video, a guy came up to me that recognized me from my Arabic Facebook. I have a big following on Facebook in Arabic. So it's on Facebook and TikTok. I think on Facebook I'm at 300,000 followers the time of this video. And on TikTok I have 150,000 followers. So that's one of the reasons I haven't focused on my English vlogs or videos, because Arabic took my time. The minute my Arabic started performing well, I just doubled down on it the past year and a half. And before that, I used to post English, but not consistently. And the key with YouTube is to post consistently, as you guys know. I have a bigger video from this market that I'll upload right after this, hopefully, or right after a different video. Let's leave here. I'm trying to leave the market faster. I want to go to the mosque. I want to get a drink and go to the mosque. So the guy that recognized me, I got some food for us. I told him, meet me at the mosque. He said he hasn't seen this market before. He's been a student here. He never knew these kind of markets existed, which is crazy to me, but it kind of makes sense, because as a student, especially an international student, not only that you're on a budget, but you probably don't, you know, you don't really mix with the locals as much as you should, but it's kind of tough. So I'm not sure. I gotta ask him what's the reason. Let me get some drinks. Well, I want two drinks. Two. I don't know which one's. Which one's good?
This one good.
Thai tea.
Thai tea, but with honey.
Give me two.
Yeah. Big cup or small cup?
Pick up.
Okay.
Oh yeah, mix it up good. How am I gonna carry all these?
I think.
Let's figure it out. Thank you. These were six apiece. So $1.25. This is faster. So if you come to the market and you want to walk by faster, you just pass it like this. Let's go to the mosque right now. Let's break our fast in a bit. So iftar is in a bit. We'll break the fast and then I'm gonna continue the video from there. So right across the street from the market is the mosque. I've filmed this place so many times, but for my Arabic channel, for the other video. Salam alaikum, brother. How are you, brother? Okay, let's go in. They're passing out the food already. I put my my stuff that I grabbed, I put it there already. Let's go stand in line, grab some food. And they give a good portion. Every time I come here, it's a good portion. But I still get more food just to share with the people around me. We have rice and meat with some sauce. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you. With some banana and lettuce. And I want some dates. These are, thank you. Dates are very important in Ramadan. Dates are very important in life, period. And everybody's sitting on the inside first, just in case it rains. And there's more sitting here. Ya Allah, ya Allah. The mic was turned off and I was filming. This is us sitting here waiting for iftar. This is my friend Amr Malik from the UK, also a YouTuber. And this is Mohammed, he's from Iraq. He's been here 5 months as a student, studying in Kuala Lumpur. Just met him at the market. All right, guys, we just finished prayer. I need some coffee. When you're fasting, you need coffee. Brother, where you at? This brother over here was talking. Brother, you like the camera. Come on, man. Give me. Tell me where you are, bro. Here. This brother likes. He likes the camera. Here you go, bro.
I don't speak Al Arabia.
English.
I don't speak English.
You speak English?
No.
What is this? What's the name of the place?
My name Soban.
Soban. And the name restaurant?
Marina. Yes, Marina Dea Cafe.
And the name of the street?
Robica Cafe.
No, the street.
Jalan Raja Muda Musa. Kuala Lumpur.
So Jalan?
Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur, Jalan Raja Muda Musa, Kampung Baru.
Okay, brother, one coffee, please. One good. Last time you got me good coffee.
Okay, no problem.
Strong.
Strong.
But sweet.
Okay.
Please, brother. I need to wake up.
Where are you from?
Iraq.
California.
Alaikum salam, brother.
كيف حالك?
Alhamdulillah. كيف حالك?
Alhamdulillah.
And you? It's Malaysia.
Malaysia. Oh, sorry.
I need coffee, man. First coffee, then we'll do the video.
Can you guys? I'm trying to fix a camera here. One of the legs on my tripod thingy broke. So I'm trying to see, and I forgot it's 12:30, so I can't be yelling. But I want to finish this video, and it's hot outside. But anyway, so it's very. So why did I move to Kuala Lumpur? Being able to move to any city. I love Southeast Asia, just like a lot of people love it. It's very safe. People are very friendly. The food is amazing. The prices are low. That's the main thing. Flights are cheap. A lot of countries in the world you can go to. And it's advanced in a lot of things, right? So that's a good reason to want to move to Southeast Asia. I tried Thailand. I really like Thailand, but I feel like this city to me is a lot better than Bangkok. I don't drink, I don't party, so that lifestyle is not for me. And as a Muslim, being in a Muslim city is really nice. And the good thing is Kuala Lumpur is mixed, right? Like Malaysia is, I think 64-65% Muslim. If I'm wrong, I'm sorry, but I think that's what Google has said. So it just means that there's a good enough balance to where being from the US, I'm used to obviously not living in a Muslim environment. So this has the good balance, but it's nice to live around Muslims. That's why when I came here in 2019, I was like, wow, I gotta live in this city. And finally, when I got burnt out of traveling, I can't travel anymore as much. So I can't full-time travel. I know I don't upload a lot. Actually, this is a thing in my new channel. I'm not sure if I'm uploading this on the new channel or my old channel, but I made a new channel because I feel like I need a fresh start. So even when I was traveling full time, I didn't have the time or the energy or even the focus of uploading and constantly uploading and editing and all that. And I kind of want to focus on that. It might be a little late. It might not be. I'm not sure. But I really don't care because my main goal was traveling. It wasn't becoming a travel YouTuber. It was traveling and filming at the same time. If it worked out, cool. If it didn't, that is what it is. But alhamdulillah, it worked in Arabic. So in Arabic language, I have good followers. Mostly from Iraq, so that's good, thank God. Now I'm hoping I can do the same with English. So if you guys watch this and you've made it so far, that means you kind of enjoy it or you're curious to see what I'm about. I hope you follow the page. I have a couple of videos that I already filmed in here in Malaysia. I'm gonna upload Kuala Lumpur. I'm gonna do an apartment tour of my little apartment with the view. I don't know where, because there's no view there right now. And yeah, I love Malaysia, I love Malaysians, I love the food here, I love the culture, and I'm hoping that they'll welcome me in calling this home, temporary, or for a short time, or at least have it as a base where I can leave my stuff, have an apartment, leave, record other countries, come back, edit, and do the same. So that's the main reason I'm calling this home, because I want to be on this side of the world. The US is too far, too expensive, not enough culture for me. Very dead. Everybody's just stuck on paying student loans off, and just the culture is just dirty to me. When I was young, I didn't feel it. I didn't care for it. It didn't affect me as much. Now it's getting worse. And this isn't an anti-American speech. This is just personal opinion of what's going on in the US. And financially, economically, it's getting harder and harder, which obviously makes it hard. So yeah, that's it. That's as basic as it gets, literally. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope I made sense. I don't know. And you guys saw my routine while I'm here. It's very basic. It's Ramadan right now. After Ramadan, we'll be seeing more of Malaysia. But meanwhile, I will be uploading my other videos from other countries. I'm still trying to figure out what format and how I'm going to do it. But I filmed a lot, so hopefully we can post some good stuff. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys like and subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. Thanks a lot. See you guys next video. Peace.